Welcome to the Beyond the Press channel.
Hello.
I'm Lauri.
And I'm Anni.
And today we are going to do a video how the hydraulic press that we use on all our videos actually works.
Yep.
So we go through all the switches and levers. So then you know what we do when we crush some shit.
And in same time, this is like anniversary video because our first hydraulic press channel video went viral exactly 2 years ago.
Yeah, and this is a bit shorter video because we are in quite a hurry. We have 3 filming days this week and we have a lot to do before those. But I figured that we haven't actually done video like this in a long time. I think on our first workshop tour there is something like this, but it's quite poor quality, so I think it's good to do it again. So the press has mine power switch here. This is in our intro, isn't it? Yeah, it is.
Yeah?
Yeah? So you can switch the pump on and off from here. And when this is off, nothing doesn't work because everything is like hydraulically controlled, so they need pressure. And I go through everything without the pump because it's quite noisy. So this is like the mine lever. It just moves the press up and down, and it doesn't move if I don't hold here. So when I like release it, it returns on the middle here. This switch over here, where is also a string. This is high pressure switch. So this goes up to 150 bar, and if you want more, then you have to pull from here. And it's really strange. I haven't seen this anywhere else. I don't know what is the system inside. I haven't never like take this part, but I think there might be like 2 pumps, and this is for the smaller high pressure pump, because if you have really big pump you can go fast but with low pressure. Otherwise if you have high speed and high pressure, then you need shitload of power and it's probably too much for the electric motor. So there is probably smaller pump, which is low, but it has really high pressure, so it goes slower, but it can crush more. And this goes up to 250 bar. It's limited with pressure valve. Pumps go always like, if you have just a pump, it will go until it breaks. So you have to always have pressure relief valve, and with that valve you can set up the maximum pressure for the system, and it's 250 bars. And then here is secondary pressure valve, so you can adjust this, and even if you completely screw this to maximum, it doesn't go over 250. But with this we can set the pressure, for example, on the 50 bars. So this is like for everyday use, and the other one is inside of the press and you aren't meant to touch that. It's really usual thing to have on the press. You have usually always 2 pressure valve. One that they set on the factory, and then the second one that press operator can use every day. And then we have only one switch left, and this lowers and raises the table. I think we have to show that. So there is pins that hold the table in its place. And I take now the pins away. And now there is these small cylinders on both sides. And with those we can raise or lower or raise the table. So we can fit bigger stuff there. Usually we have it in this position. And this is huge pain in the ass to adjust the table. If we are crushing something and it doesn't fit here, we are both always like It doesn't feel good because it's like hard work. These are really heavy and they don't ever fit there nicely. So you have to like... use a lot of force and it's like... yeah, pretty nice. Handle from this one, it flies away with some explosion. Do you want to remember what was the explosion?
Some paper explosion.
It was paper or pulp.
Yep.
And there was huge explosion and this flies away. So that was pretty interesting. Can you want to push that? This is like Anni's side.
Yep.
Anni always pulls these out and puts them back in. And I put this side and operate the lever. And now we can do demonstration cross with this car. And we are going to now demonstrate the different pressure levels. So first one, I have this completely open. But because it's really big cylinder, it's still going to have at about 10 tons of force. So the car would be quite flat. Yeah. It was actually here. It is now 25 bars. And if I screw this in, the pressure goes up. And the car goes more and more flat. And now I shut it completely. Like this. And then I use this. I think it doesn't matter much because the car is already quite flat. Yeah, some movement but not much. Usually with all like our new special tools, we need only this lever. We cannot use full pressure. The slicer or extruder and other stuff, they got destroyed if I use full power. And then on like everything that is made out of like rubber, plastic, this is usually enough. And then like steel stuff and paper, this is like good choice. When I reach this lever, Anni goes like this. And I'm also, it's like we always take care that everything is safe. But even if you are like behind the blast screen and far away, it's always like, it's not always pleasant feeling to use this. Because you have to have like everything correctly here. For example, if the thing that you are crossing is a bit offset, you can destroy the machine. And you have to like really know what you are doing when you are using full force. And sometimes even this isn't enough. So here we have two different tools. And if we have some big things that we are going to destroy, we might use first this one. But because the force isn't actually the thing that breaks stuff, it's the pressure. And the pressure is force divided by surface area that you are applying the force. And this has so big surface area that the pressure under this, it might be only something like 1,000 bars. And it isn't enough, for example, paper. So if the thing doesn't go with this, then we change the tool to this. And now we have probably only fifth of the area of this here. So we have 5 times the pressure against the thing that we are crushing. And this is... this is quite small tool for the force, and usually this destroys everything. And second problem after too low pressure, when crushing hard things, is too soft tools. With these tools, these are like just steel, it's quite high quality, like it's chromium molybdenum or something like that steel. So it's much tougher than regular steel. but it's still not hardened. And usually we use this, because if this got damaged, I can just like take a couple millimeters with the lathe off and then it's okay. But this won't be able to crush like bearing balls and stuff like that, because they just sink into this. And for that one we have hardened tools. And these are, I think they are HRC, or what is the like measurement of hardness? These are 60, and they are, the hardened layer is 5 millimeters thick, so these are really hard pieces of the steel. And bearing ball leaves only this amount of dent when it goes, or probably we have done a couple with these. And these are from the shrapnel from the bearing ball, because they fly almost 1 kilometer per second, so they leave some marks here. But the bearing balls, if you have like, you have to have on down on top these, and it goes between those, and then you are able to crush it. And then we have, of course, like our typical stuff, the blades and stuff that we have done this year. And usually it's like not good idea to put anything hardened inside of the press, because hardened things can explode. And when you are crushing with these, you have to be behind like really thick blast shield. And when we started, we didn't know how much of force the machine can produce. But we made the video with Inspector where we tested, and it was 144 tons. So it's like, it's more than your typical workshop press, but it isn't any means like huge number. But one thing is really cool on this machine for YouTube videos. It's quite wide, and it's not very like a solid machine. It bends quite a lot when you apply the full force. And you can see it on many of our videos that the table goes down something like 6 millimeters with full power. And when it does that, it's like giant and really stiff spring. And when the thing that you are crushing breaks down, the table is free to move up. And also the hydraulic cylinder, because the oil compress in big pressures, not much, but much more than water. So this is also like spring. And the thing that you are crushing is between two giant springs. And when the thing breaks, like the playing cards or bearing ball or paper or anything like that, the table goes up and this goes down, so it's like double destruction. First you crush it and then you hit it with giant hammer. And because this moves up, everything on the table, like GoPros and stuff from previous crushes, fly up, and they look really nice in the slow motion. Usually I like to have some shit laying around here when we are crushing stuff. So when things explode and I use the high speed footage, people can see how slow that really is, because the things that were on the table are just like hanging in the air and it looks really nice. Yeah, is there anything else? Do you Anni have anything to add?
I like the color.
Yeah, and I can so, this is my own upgrade. This wasn't from the factory. Because we used to use blast seal over here, but it was a bit problematic because it tends to block the cameras. So nowadays we don't use anything here if we are not doing something really stupid. For example, the bearing balls have to have like blast seals all around. We have them. They go like here, so you can take them off and put in. But nowadays we use this over here, we are behind that. And then the cameras are here, we can buy new cameras if those got broken. And then we have this. It's like really good method. We just put the thing here, machine on, go behind the cover. So we can safely crush some stuff without the blast screen. Yeah, but I think that is all about how we use the press. If you want to know something else from this or other machines, we can do videos about those also. First we thought that we are going to do video about basics on working with lathe, and Anni would be like student and I'm going to teach Anni how to turn, and then you would learn with the Anni, but we didn't have time for that video, so we made this instead. But I think this is pretty interesting, and now you know how this works. But the lathe video is coming later. Yeah, but that is all for today.
Thanks for watching.
And have a nice day.